we just took it slow. They said your girlfriend's from the beaches. It's funny how everybody but me knows. I feel like you feel nothing, that's fine. Please leave this behind. You're losing your mind. Calling me 100 times. Time you drew a line and stopped wasting mine. Miss me, that's a lie. I Now that I'm over that hill, you wanna say how you feel. Crazy to think that you still call me psycho. You wanna talk, not ideal. Heard I moved on, babe, that's real. And you got a girl, but
are there.
Yeah, something just a little bit different, right? Why not? Why not? A little poppy, right?
I think I'm a psycho. Hey, wait a minute.
What does that microphone sound as opposed to the other one?
I don't know. Maybe you're not plugged in all the way?
Jacob, why don't you just take the...
Hello? Yeah.
Yeah, that's better. There you go.
Why don't you take this guy off and hold that? I mean, how does that sound compared to these? Do you think it makes a huge difference?
Oh, stupidly. For sure. I can see it right here. There's like zero echo.
Yeah, why don't you just pop this guy out and hold the Rodecaster? You don't need this or anything, but hold this mic.
It's not a big deal.
Okay.
Yeah. I am fine. Thank you, though, for your concern.
I'm just here to help.
I understand. Like I said. I appreciate you.
I wasn't concerned. That was micromanaging.
It was a microaggression, Evan. Whatever that means.
You know, Jacob, I was a couple episodes. You just weren't quite sparky enough, okay?
Sparky?
Yeah, sparky.
Sparky.
Yeah.
You missed a perfect lead in.
Yeah, so I'm going to need you to be a little more sparky.
All right.
Now, yeah, that'd be great.
He says that wearing that shirt.
Right. Evan is wearing...
Yeah, see, I came possibly from a golf tournament earlier.
Right.
And, yeah.
Apparently, he blew Tiger Woods.
Yep, blew Tiger Woods for this shirt.
I have sunglasses on, and it still looks like it's glowing radioactively.
It is very green.
I had three Bloody Marys. I don't know what happened. It took over me. And
I got
a cool shirt out of it, though.
You only had three Bloody Marys across 18 holes of golf. I refuse to believe that.
No, I don't even like Bloody Marys.
But being on a golf course is different, though. On a golf course, you do like Bloody Marys.
No, I probably lean towards mimosas.
Really?
Yeah.
No.
Not unless it had like full entree sticking out of the Bloody Mary. Like there's those places that make ridiculous Bloody Marys.
No. That's not what I would want. I would want
to eat all the food and then probably not even drink the thing.
That's actually his wedding getup.
Mm-hmm.
Who's he getting married to? She-Hulk?
No. Just that's what he wears to any wedding.
Oh, I see.
That's not true. I've got a suit now.
It's a monkey suit, though.
No, I have one of those, too. No, I literally do. I have a monkey onesie and a suit. That's all that's hanging in my closet.
So you put the onesie on and then the suit over that?
I mean, I could do it either way around.
Those really cold Bigfoot winter nights.
Yeah, right. For sure.
I'll tell you what. The first one that we actually get our shit together and we get this video, you know, starting going into the YouTube realm a little bit more or the live podcast realm, I will wear it the first episode that we fully go video.
Okay.
I'll wear the monkey onesie. And I mean, I guess it's up to you guys. If you want me to wear it over the suit, you want me to wear a suit over the monkey onesie, we can go either way with this. It's going to be really hot.
Right. And I'll wear fucking pigtails.
I hope it's during the winter because that's going to be hot.
I can do all sorts of shit with my hair.
Your hair is pretty long. I think what we should do one episode is get that hair paste, whatever the fuck they use to make those giant fucking mohawks.
Come.
All right, this may take a couple weeks to gather that much cum, but I think we could do it.
We made it 6 minutes. 6 minutes into that before you had to say some dumb shit. What he really meant to say, and what we've been meaning to say as well, is that this is SoulPods.
Well, they should know it's fucking SoulPods by now. What the fuck are they on? Sorry. This is SoulPods.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Try not to berate our listeners, Evan.
Right.
And we love you.
Shout out to just the state of Florida in general. I can't really tell due to the dynamics and stuff like that of our podcast platform that we use, but we had like almost 80 episodes downloaded just in Florida last month. So word the fuck up. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Floridians.
Yeah. That's dope. You know, tell all your friends, listen to SoulPods.
Yes.
We aren't bad. We aren't bad. You know, we're pretty decent. We're okay at the podcast game for being amateurs the way that we are.
Total amateurs. We do our best.
Sorry for missing last week. We're closing in on like 75 actual episodes, right? Like not just like mini episodes and stuff like that, but like legitimate actual talks, which is pretty cool. It's pretty crazy to think like that's closer to 100 than not. You know?
Yeah, and we are starting to get into kind of some deeper episodes as well. Right. You know, some better talks, some better material, but those do take a little bit longer to research as well.
Yeah, and there's been a couple of spans where we're doing stuff more like today, letting our balls hang out, freeballing episodes. But I don't know. There's the thing you guys have to realize: we still have a life. We don't do this for a living or anything, so we get busy. And so that's what last week was. We all just got a little busy and it was in everyone's best interest to go ahead and take a week off. We don't do it very often, but we decided to do it this time.
It was also sometimes, our friend's birthday last week on Tuesday. So
there is that as well. Right. There was just a plethora of things that went into it to where we just decided, fuck it, you know.
Yeah, my end of things, I pretty much custom fabricated this really cool little food truck trailer. And at the beginning of the week on Monday, it was a bare frame. And by the end of the week, it catered a wedding on Saturday. So within a week, we custom built all this stuff, badass smoker, flat top grill, fryer, 3-well steam well with a cold well and a hot keeper well for the fryer and built-in cutting board. Like it was super cool. It was a fun project.
Right, right. And, you know, obviously that takes time.
It takes a lot of time. You know? Plus I have a normal job on top of that.
Right. And then there's that as well.
And in other news, I recently changed jobs, actually.
Right, right.
I'm no longer a plumber. I'm now a kind of everything guy.
I see.
Top to bottom building, basically really fancy modular homes.
This is all a euphemism, right?
Could be. But no, basically these big fucking, they're trailer homes, technically. There's two of them and they get married together. And I mean, they're not your typical modular homes, though. They're pretty fancy, pretty nice.
Does a modular home stork bring a baby after they get married?
I'm not going to respond to that. But basically, top to bottom, framing the thing, drywall, everything, tile, plumbing, the whole nine yards. But I'm excited about it.
9 yards is small square footage.
Okay, that nail kind of landed a little bit, but come on.
It's a lot of bullets, though.
Yeah, well, that's the American way. Shoot first, shoot second, shoot some more, and when everyone's dead, hopefully.
Maybe you think about some stuff.
Right. Maybe.
Maybe.
Maybe, maybe,
maybe. Look, I'm a little off, but I haven't had any time to prepare any jokes. I'm just going off the cuff.
Right. We took a week off. We don't know how to do this anymore.
Yeah, you're right. I barely know my name is Muzzy.
And I'm Jake, I think, for the most part.
I'm almost certain, like 95% Evan is what it is.
And this is SoulPods, and it's wonderful to see you again. And hopefully you enjoy what you're going to hear, which is just going to be a lot of, you know,
bullshit.
And, you know, it'll probably be a shorter episode. So, you know, don't expect a lot of anything out of it. This is what we call filler.
Right.
Yes.
Maybe a hidden nugget of wisdom
now. And we've got a subject that we're going to be bringing up here in the next couple weeks, I believe. What is it? Three-parter?
I don't know.
I'd say at least two.
I don't want to commit to anything.
I'd say two. I think we can make two out of it. So
just expect 2 to 4. We'll call it that.
Yeah.
Somewhere in that
vicinity.
Maybe more, maybe not. But for right now, I don't know. What do you want to talk about? You said you had something that you wanted to rant about for a second, so.
Yeah, I do. Go for it. So the FBI, right? No, we've talked about the FBI a couple of times before, especially when it relates to little kids and the things that they don't do about the people that hurt little kids, and the way they aid and abet these people. We've talked about that before, but the FBI seems intent on going even further than that. These are people who are like just raided a black socialist organization the other day because of a whisper of a possible connection with a Russian person. Like, completely raided their shit, like SWAT team style. And
really?
Yeah.
Lovely.
That's just wonderful.
And this is what they're doing instead of catching pedophiles.
Right. Which would be the main focus for, you know, every organization of law enforcement that we can possibly utilize to, you know, make that happen.
Exactly. Like, these people are obviously not doing their jobs. They're acting as some sort of political task force and going at people who are against the narrative. It's a very interesting dynamic, but that's exactly what the FBI is at this point. They're nothing but a political task force, almost like a secondary wing of the CIA.
Right. Like, they kind of fall underneath the umbrella of that, you know, and like I brought about the FBI as well before, too, was they're supposed to be the idea of having a bureau of our best trained people who investigate crimes on a national level is good if you can run it correctly. And everybody is trained really thoroughly. And then you have a, you know, task force of people who are specially trained to handle certain things, right? Outside of what would be defined as normal police work, like catching serial killers and catching pedophiles and doing things like that, right? Like, instead, it seems like we have a cover-up force that just works as the kind of blanket over a lot of these, you know, like, we've talked about it in Missing 411, how sometimes the FBI will show up, and it's really weird that they do that. Like, why? You're not involved. Why are you there?
Yeah, they don't even.
Check. I mean, you're on here. It's your mic. It's probably like the cord to your mic, not your headphone.
Yeah, you could in.
I don't know about that, but
yeah, there you go.
I mean, maybe it was. Didn't have much room to go in, though. I'll tell you that.
Well, I'll tell you that. That's, you adjusted your headphone twice, and that's, you touched that once, and it worked. So
Fair enough.
Two times you were wrong, one time I was right. I think that's enough.
Yeah, but two negatives definitely make a positive, I think. So.
And one Trojan horse destroyed, you know.
I was about to say, da-da-da-da, Muzzy finally found the clitoris. Okay, I'm done.
He gave you an achievement. That was what just happened right there.
Yeah, but it's like 30 years too late. I mean, Pastor Elizabeth was...
Pastor Elizabeth.
Hey, man, it took me 15, 38 bad, dude.
Jesus.
I know. Jesus. I know. Let me make something absurd even more absurd.
Right. Sister Eunice would have been better.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Yeah.
Just saying. But so the one really dangerous thing though about the FBI that has come up here in the past like week or so is that recently it has come out that the Ancestry.com and the 23andMe websites, all that DNA that you've been given to them, the FBI now has all of that DNA. They're keeping it. They have a database now of you. Here's the scary part. Because just like a few days after that happened, after that leak happened, the FBI comes out and says that Russia has that DNA and they're going to create individual bioweapons so they can attack you individually. But the FBI has the DNA. How did Russia get the DNA? Unless Russia doesn't have the DNA. Seems
so
to
me, up in the fucking air right now.
It would seem to me that this would be another blatant example of America trying to blame something on someone else that they are in fact doing.
Yeah, you know, and also it is just a like a play on how stupid they think the public is as well, right? Like you're going to create individual bioweapons. Could you please explain to me what that means? How does that work? Can you tell me how we are targeted individually, unless you mean that
with
the release of a gas that releases some type of virus or something like that in it? That's not every virus is an individually targeted thing. Sorry, that was my computer's lagging a little bit.
So all you need is a very probably at least I would guess all you need is a certain gene to react.
What I mean is, are they going to have a bunch of dudes running around, hiding in bushes, blow darting people with a virus on an individual basis? Because that's kind of what you're going to target the individual, right? Like that's what you kind of conjure into people's minds of people stalking them to give them a virus.
No.
With a biochemical weapon, like.
It would be very hard to do something like that unless you were an actual threat to them, okay? So here's my question to you. Who do you think is the most expendable of the elite?
Like currently, like right now, like Joe Biden.
Like who is the most expendable of any one of them?
Joe Biden.
Who going forward would have the least influence?
Joe Biden.
So maybe he catches one of these individual bioengineered diseases. And then they're all like, oh, look, see, it fucking happened. We told you it was going to happen. And look, they attacked our president.
Well, what does that mean? Individually? Do they literally have scientists committed to a single person to make them sick, or is it a shifting antigen?
No, I think it would be a lot harder to make something individual for one person. I think it's a lot easier to make something that just a gene in the DNA strand reacts to. That's why I said that.
So yeah,
still targeted, but
sure. But, yeah, I mean, it would just be a variant kind of
shifting. Much broader than one person. Yeah,
sure. But even then, like that's very akin to. Like the stand from Stephen King, right? Like the virus that ends up killing most of everybody in the world is like this shifting antigen flu virus that you can't control, because every time your body produces antibodies to it, it just shifts.
On the other hand, the last two diseases that have come out now have literally been worked with at the Wuhan lab.
And what you have to look at here, too, is what the WHO has been doing. So, sure. I mean, they're onto some spooky, you know, New World Order type stuff.
And I see that. And
they're like, they can overpower governments at this point. If another COVID breaks out or something like that, I guess it would be monkeypox at this point.
I mean, that's a state of emergency already got declared for monkeypox.
California, New York, and I want to say something like Vermont or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Already.
Yeah, these are some of the most liberal places in our country, though, as well, which is why they're terribly run, by the way.
They're grouping to try and subdue this.
And it's not because they're liberals that they're terribly run. They're terribly run because they're run by morons.
Yeah. And ultimately, that's what that comes down to. You know, Vermont is probably the least occupied of all of those, but like New York, right? Well, you could make the excuse that it is a very, you know, a central importing and exporting hub, right, for the United States, for like goods wise. There's just so many people on such little land. They're already super packed in, and like controlling that many people is impossible. When they're stacked on top of each other like that, and they live the way that they do in certain parts, like
I honestly think it's very rich for New York to think that they can do anything for the health of their city when they couldn't even give healthcare to the fucking 9/11 workers that were dying of asbestos poisoning because of the cloud that hung over that city.
Right.
For like 15 fucking years, they waited for healthcare.
Yeah, it's a joke. It's a total joke.
So, yeah, New York can shut the fuck up when it comes to healthcare. You don't have a say. You lost that right.
Right. But they're bracing. They're trying to just get people under control because they know what's coming, which is.
They don't know what's coming.
Well, I mean, they know what's coming economy-wise. They know, like.
Well, everyone knows what's coming economy-wise. Did you hear the White House press secretary the other day? She's being asked about the economy, about, like, the fact that we're in a recession. Everyone fucking knows that. There was even a poll that was put out. Like, over half the country thinks we're already in a recession, which we are. Right. It's very easy to see. But then they're changing the definition of what a recession is. Just like they did with anti-vax, just like they did with vaccinated. Like, and then on top of that, she can't even answer the fucking questions about it. They're like, oh, well, we don't define recession like that. So, you know, we're not.
Yeah, we are.
Right. No, we totally are. We totally are. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, none of
these. They keep coming out and saying shit like, oh, no, the country is the strongest it's ever been. The economy is growing. There's more. There's less unemployment, and wages are going up, blah, 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 blah. Fuck it, you, dude.
And it's like,
and gas prices are dropping. Yeah. So his biggest thing lately is
none
gas
of that is true.
Dropping.
Yeah.
Yeah. Motherfucker, you fucking, that shit was at $2 last year.
Yeah. You know,
what the fuck happened to that? You're stoked about bringing it from fucking 490 to 420.
You know, he's playing the oldest game that retail stores play with you, which is right around, you know, Black Friday, Christmas time. They slowly jack the prices up and then they drop them down to.
That's a perfect example of what's going on.
And you get stoked because suddenly this TV that you don't remember because you weren't looking at it because it wasn't the holidays was only $400 in April. Suddenly now is on sale for $600 on Black Friday, priced at $1,200 for the actual TV, right? It's all a fucking lie. They're just using it as this kind of, I guess, it's a retail signal. It's a super old trick that they have, and they're just doing that with, like, they jacked it up almost $5 here in Colorado, at least, right? And then they, look, it dropped so much because we don't remember. With the survivalist mindset that so many people are now in, that gas prices only used to be
And objectively, it seems like fraud. Yeah. But,
you know, no, and is. So we're stoked that's that exactly it's almost $4, right?
That's what I'm saying.
It's falling like, inflation of the price.
Look at these falling gas prices. That's me. Like, yeah, we also fucking raised them, dude.
But no, but
it might not be solely his
falling fault. Gas prices. It's funny to hear him say the word falling in anything when he can't even walk upstairs or ride a bike.
Oh, no, falling goes hand in hand with Joe Biden. You see him fall off that bicycle?
I didn't, no.
Oh, dude, it's worth a watch.
It's the funniest for sure. Damn thing in the world, dude. It's embarrassing. This dude. It's
fucking embarrassing.
This is like your grandfather just bikes up to the old country buffet and then tries to get off of it.
And falls.
Yeah, like can't get off of it and just falls over like a fucking penguin who got pushed.
Sure. But then he'd stagger up and stand there like a penguin. I think I had too many.
He didn't stagger up. His Secret Service came and picked him up.
Of course.
That was also the funniest thing in the fucking world.
That's pretty fucking funny for sure. But I mean, it is just horrendous. Like the state of like where we find ourselves with like our political leaders, you know, and stuff like that. And like, you can't. Presidents have almost nothing to do with gas prices and the way that things like that happen, right? Yeah, like,
and that's why I said I don't solely blame him.
No,
he,
well,
he did do stuff that did influence it.
Sure. By enacting and by partaking in certain things, he caused this inflation of gas prices, right? Or the supposed inflation of gas prices that we saw, which was in reality not necessary because when you look at big oil and how much reserve we actually have here in the United States. There's no reason.
Well, we just ship reserve off. I can't remember exactly where it went. I want to say like Australia or something.
Right. And it's
something like
wherever's farthest away from America so you can get the biggest shipping price.
Yeah.
Here's the thing about this. Like
you have to look at the whole big oil companies making record profits.
No, so I was getting to that. So like at the beginning of Biden's administration, he was enacting more drilling rights than Trump did.
Yeah.
And then like this whole green backlash has happened and their green agenda now is being pushed. So we cut off a lot of that, but that's just the ones that he signed in at the beginning of his administration. We still have all the other ones. They're also working.
Right.
They're all still going. None of those have been cut off.
Right. And the government continues to petition for more and more land for drilling. And a lot of like I've seen a lot of senators and, you know, Congress people just railing these big oil companies just, you know, so directly like on the news, you know, like with no real censor and having these companies just have very little to say. Right.
Because they don't have anything to say. They need to be sanctioned the way we're sanctioning Russia, the way we're sanctioning Venezuela, the way we sanctioned Cuba. Like, this is exactly what needs to happen. And this would be one of the first things I would do is I would sanction every fucking oil company out there. You guys want to play? Now you're going to have to pay to sell your oil, you stupid motherfuckers. Like, you don't get to exploit the people of the world the way you have. And that goes for the pharmaceutical companies, too. Like, all of you people, your day of reckoning is coming, okay? I know you don't think that it is. I know you think you're completely invincible. You are not. Your head could be cut off just as easily as those motherfuckers in France. And we are much closer to that than we are closer to our politicians having any accountability at this point.
And with that...
And that is a fucking fact.
But my aim was made strong by the hand of the Almighty, forward in this generation, triumphantly, all I ever had is songs of freedom. Won't you hear me sing? emancipate ourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear.
Have no fear for atomic energy.
Oh yeah, that's some Bob Marley right there.
Yes.
Good stuff.
Always, you know, Bob stuff. Marley, the guy who
if you played the latter version, but that one's good too, obviously.
Isn't Bob Marley the guy who visited Ebenezer Scrooge on Christmas Eve?
That was our audience leaving.
Right. For those who stuck around, this is a SoulPods podcast.
That was funny.
That was good, Evan. You got a good close. That was good, funny. Dude. Good job. Good job. Killing it. Good job. Fuck.
But yeah, this is fucking SoulPods, and we are back from our break. We're all riled up.
And I'm done with my FBI rant, but I definitely needed to get that off my chest. I do have one other just really small thing. Just the whole national security and UFOs thing. They keep using the words national security when talking about UFOs, which is ridiculous to me because UFOs have been seen for, you know, thousands of years on this planet, and they've never once attacked us. So national security argument is kind of out the fucking window for me.
Right, because it's not like we don't have a precedent for this and that they haven't been here for a while, right? Like, you look at, it was in the middle of World War II. There was a giant, a UFO over LA that the government shelled the fuck out of 4 hours and nothing happened. You know, like it just.
Yeah, they don't attack us. They don't need to.
Yeah, it was. I mean,
they're strictly observing. If they are there, they're strictly observing.
You know what? I'm actually going to fact check that story because I feel like it is way more intense than like just making out like that. Like they hit it with like 2,800 bombs.
Yeah,
like
no. There were lots of bullets fired at this thing.
Yeah, they for a long time and like. They were just exploding in midair.
Yeah, they had air raid sirens. Like, it might as well have been a fucking 4th of July party.
Right. And it wasn't just an exercise. Like, there are pictures, you know, but, like, unfortunately, of course, we don't have the luxury of having 4K-worthy pictures in, you know, early 20th century photography.
Then again, if they could make that all that World War II footage in color...
Right, but I feel like film is slightly different than printed news unless we have the negatives. Then totally, for sure. That's where the enhancement comes from. But by just having like a copy of a newspaper, it's like a Xerox of a Xerox, right? Like
I gotcha.
Unfortunately, right?
But yeah, I just wanted to point that out. Like, it's kind of ridiculous to use the national security argument when they've never attacked us. I did get a few people... coming back at me with the whole abduction thing. But they don't seem to be hurting people. I mean, yeah, psychiatrically or psychologically, yeah, you're going to be fucked up, probably emotionally as well. But it's not like you're coming back missing a limb. They're not doing those kinds of things, you know? Like, you're not physically traumatized necessarily.
Like, I would like to think that if we did have an alien in Area 51, we probably killed it. And then basically did an autopsy on it.
Well, I've heard a few different stories that I've never heard before that, like, unfortunately, like, this is just kind of like, this is the story that I have to tell, right? It's not a verified thing. This is supposedly, right? Like, I worked for, you know, this place during this time, and there was, you know, before, actually, like, before I speak on it, basically there was like a massacre that happened because of human overreaction to these grays that they had that were at this facility, not Area 51, but a different facility that apparently fucked up like an entire squadron of security guards that were supposed to, you know, not just like military, like I'll look it up. You guys just continue to talk, but it's very interesting.
Not saying it was aliens, man. It was aliens. So what's your honest opinion, Muzzy? I think I know your answer. I know your answer.
Well, my answer is illegal aliens.
I mean, Home Depot, you go pick a few of them up, labor's cheap, gets the job done, and I mean, that's it, right?
Why do you do this? You couldn't, like, you went the wrong way.
Went the money-making way.
No, but you didn't go the further joke way.
Money's not joke.
Yes, it is.
But no, I mean, you obviously think there's aliens out there, right?
Of course I do. But I don't think they're out to hurt us. I really don't. I think they could have at any point in time, and they haven't. And even if they were studying us for some malevolent reason, like they've been doing it for thousands of years, don't you think they would have had all the information they need to completely wipe us off the face of the planet if they wanted to?
Thousands of years.
Like, I don't know. Maybe I'm the only one that thinks that, but it just seems to me pretty obvious that if they wanted to, they could take us out.
Yeah, I mean, if they had the capability of reaching us, I would say, yeah, they have the technology to completely decimate us with a small fleet.
I mean, we've shot at them and they haven't done anything. They haven't even reacted.
Well, yeah, it's interesting. They're far past that. They're where we would be at in, you know, 1500 years.
Yeah, it's like Floyd Mayweather, you know, dodging Frankie's punches.
Hey, he can throw a couple hooks, dude. That's all I got. What else is happening? What else? Joking.
What's happening?
What is happening?
So apparently, there is this base near the New Mexico Colorado border called the Dulce base, right? Here, supposedly, there were grays that like lived in this base. And this one dude reported that while he was working there, there were, let's see exactly what it says.
Yeah, so basically there's grays and there's doms, and the other one ties the other one up, and you know what I mean?
Right. Shit. It doesn't give the actual number. Fuck. But there was either one, just one of them, I think is actually what it was. And this dude who worked there said that it was talking with all of these scientists and shit, and one of the Delta Force guys that they deploy down there came in armed, and the gray just like sensing that it was in danger just killed this dude, right? Like it was he described it like a reactionary thing. It saw the weapon and recognized that it could hurt it, and it was told that there would be nothing that was going to happen like that, and it's just like a reactive instinct. It eliminated the threat immediately, right? Which then, as the United States government would of course see it, that is a hostile action from an alien force, literally, right? So they deployed a squad of Delta Force commandos, 60 of them, to this base to keep this alien or aliens in this base, basically, right? It killed like 40 of them and all of the scientists that were there, apparently. This comes from like one guy who supposedly worked there who came out and said that this is what happened. So take with that what you will, right? But
I take from that America thinks they can do whatever they want again, and as soon as somebody else does what America does, they get mad. That's exactly what the fuck that sounds like.
Yeah. It was...
Is why you even have a fucking Delta Force anybody down there. That is not what they're used for. He came down there to kill that thing. Like, these are people who like infiltrate other countries, you know? These are people who like assassinate targets. These are not people who go into some base where there's an alien unless they're going to kill it.
Right.
It's just the way our military works, y'all.
Right. It's funny how there are like little things like that, like people just kind of don't know about. And it is just because it's just like one person who's giving this account saying like, no, this happened, but you know, where Area 51 is such like a widespread base and shit like that. And it was so mysterious that even if it wasn't nefarious with the government, sometimes it seems like they just keep secrets for no reason, you know? And it's weird to us that they do. And I heard this.
It's called red herrings.
It just shows the sickness of our government, right? Like the compulsivity of their lies and cover up for what seems like no reason, right? We all know it's there, but apparently it's not. You can see it, but that's not what it is. It's not there. Like, what kind of magical fucking thinking do you actually have to convince yourself that that's true? And like, what kind of shit?
I mean, these are people for them to believe that too. These are like, people who think other countries don't know anything about our military capabilities. They do. They do know what we can do.
Well, no shit. Otherwise, there'd be a whole lot more going on right now.
Well, my guess though is that the maintenance on a lot of our technology and weaponry has been lacking, just like any other infrastructure in our country. So, like all of those weapon systems that no one knows how to use that we're selling to Ukraine, and they don't know how to use them, and we have like three people that can go over there and train them. Like, it's pretty fucking hilarious. Remember the Navy? They can't even take off and land an airplane. Crash 3 times in a week. Like, this is the state of our military. And let's not forget the last war we actually got into. We lost a 20-year war to guerrilla armies.
But hey, remember, they just released that new Tom Cruise movie, and you're wrong, because Tom Cruise says that we can fly airplanes. And we got a lot of young kids who can fly airplanes, too. And that's how you keep the morale up with, you know, bread and shows.
Exactly. That's why I don't like military movies, because they're just propaganda.
I refuse to see that movie, not because of, you know, any deep political thing or because it's propaganda or anything, just because why?
Oh no, I have plenty of reasons not to see the movie.
You know,
that's Hollywood's whole game right now, is basically they're just remaking shit. That's all they got. They can't get creative at all. They're just looking for cash cows that they know are going to make money.
Right.
That's what's been going on for the last 5-6 years.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Right, 25.
Meanwhile, there are some shows that are out on like Netflix and Hulu and stuff like that, like that they're just making, that are fire, right? Good. And it just shows that like the era of how we perceive things and take things in and what we want from our media ingestion has way outpaced what they can give us. And it's proof that, you know, when they talk about their viewing audience, they're talking about a much older, different generation of people who are watching the actual news every night, like people like my mom, my dad.
Right, because it's not us or anyone younger.
Well,
right,
you also have to think about how, I mean, you know, the older generation has still kept cable, but the younger generation has completely gotten rid of cable. And you know, back in the day, it'd be like $80 a month, you know, whatever.
Right.
And they built up a system to where now you're paying over $80. You're basically purchasing it like pay-per-view every time.
Right.
And that money goes directly in their pockets.
Right. And we also, as our generation has evolved too, we have figured out how to do things like, you know, you have one friend who gets a Netflix, you know, account, who gives everybody else their password, and then everybody has their own profile and you just share it, right? Fucking who cares, right?
Yeah, and they're starting to put a block on that, I think.
No, they just increased the price and made it so you can have unlimited screens. Like, fucking, they don't care as long as you're paying for it. Like, ultimately, they get paid per view, just like YouTube and shit like that, you know? Like, their only adherence is to their stockholders, and all they can say is like, well, you know, we can guarantee that through...
They're not getting paid per view because they don't have advertisements. So they're getting paid for the subscriptions. That's what they're getting paid for.
No, but then they have... They also don't have ads. Like, they have rights to certain shows and stuff like that. Like, the incentives are there, right? And I'm not saying...
Not to mention any of their own shows. That's all their money.
Yeah. I'm not saying that it's perfect or anything like that, but YouTube is definitely the free option, but the level of workmanship that is coming from Netflix is destroying any other like regular show I've ever seen on television before ever, right? Like, they are so compelling that you really will sit there and watch what is basically a 10-hour movie if it's 10 hour-long episodes, because they make it that compelling and the writing and the acting is that good.
Yeah.
You know, like, they're killing it in that sense. And
yes, they are.
That's where people want to be at. That's what the quality that they expect is that almost, right? Like, that's like gold standard, maybe not, like, it's good for streaming. And then Hulu has also come along with that, but ultimately, it's about public interest. And so when news organizations report, who are they reporting to? What numbers are they giving to the classification of people that they're talking to? They're just spoon feeding them either one prejudice or the other, right? And then that's where you get this super duper vocal minority and screaming minority of people who make it seem like everybody who registers or thinks in one way is that way, right? Like the ultimate Karens and these, you know, whatever the male equivalent of that is. And it just fucks everything up for everybody. And I see that, I can see that, you know, Gen Z for sure has definitely moved away from, if I ask my sister about any type of current news, what was going on and where she got her sources from, it would be, oh, Facebook, TikTok, Snapchat, right? Never CNN, MSNBC. You know, that's what they said. I watched the news last night, right? Never. Like, they don't sit down to, you know, a TV guide of, oh, look, Thursday at 7 o'clock, they're playing this. We have to make sure that we watch it, right? that's a non-existent thing anymore. You can get anything for free on the internet if you don't want to pay for it too. There are thousands of websites where you can go to watch free movies and television shows and stuff that was just like in theaters and shit like that. Like, we as a generation have figured out how to just take what we want and distribute it the way that we want to without really caring and seeing how fake.
I've torrented movies forever.
Oh, dude. For sure. For sure. I know one dude who actually did get busted by the FBI, though. Like, well, straight up.
And we've had threats from, you know, our internet provider because, sure, they track that kind of stuff.
Yeah. Well, now they do, but back in the day, they sure didn't.
No.
Well, Well, at least one of them is owned by the FBI.
That's how I got my entertainment. I didn't give a shit.
Oh, yeah. And that's just the code they put in it. Yeah, fuck them.
You're still making money.
Yeah.
You hear that, Metallica? Go fuck yourselves.
Yeah, right.
For sure.
I was wondering what happened with the Stranger Things thing. Because they actually had the guy who played Eddie Munson backstage at Lollapalooza, I think it was. And they were like fucking way cool with him. But I wonder if they paid them because when you know all that thing that happened with Metallica, I wonder if they paid rights to them. The show. I was wondering that.
I don't know. I don't even know what you're talking about. Really.
It's because we don't watch Stranger Things, and it's probably better that we don't. And
I understand every single word that you said, but in the sentence that you said them in, I don't have an answer for.
So, in the latest season,
okay,
they had this badass scene. It was pretty fucking sick, honestly. All right, fine.
I want to hear. It's okay. Fuck him. He doesn't even have headphones on. He's not really part of anything right now.
It was a pretty fucking sick scene. And you know, Eddie Munson is this like classic 80s hairband teenager guy.
Yeah, sure.
And he fucking rips out a guitar and he starts playing I forgot what the song was.
Okay.
I can't remember the song, but it was badass. And that got him backstage at Lollapalooza with Metallica. But they used it in the show. So I'm wondering.
Oh, no, yeah, for sure. They definitely paid Metallica. No, for sure, for sure.
Yeah.
There's no way.
That's what I figured, too.
Yeah. So, for instance, Ryan Reynolds wanted to, like, in canon, in Deadpool is a huge Golden Girls fan. Right. And he wears a B. Arthur shirt in the Deadpool movie. Right. And they were like, yo, if you want to do that, it's going to cost this much. And so he said, cool, pay him. Fuck it. For one scene where he wore this shirt and he paid it to B. Arthur's like family or like what it was just he was so dedicated to it. And like that's why he forgets his guns, because that was like their visual effects budget basically for that. So he just sacrificed that for just being able to wear this shirt, right? Like that is dope.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah.
But I mean, I figured as friendly as they were, that's what happened is they paid him.
Oh yeah. Well, no, for sure. Like in Metallica, they made such a big stink about their music.
Yeah, for real.
That for real. Like they would,
they probably don't do anything for free. They probably don't even eat a donut in public for free.
Well, I mean, they kind of have to.
Ours or Rick doesn't.
But if, like, okay, so I saw this meme.
No. Like, he buys the donut. He looks around the donut shop and he goes, like,
who wants to pay me?
Who knows? Yeah, y'all know who I am? I ain't doing this shit for free.
Pay me. Give me like $5 for that donut. Pay me.
$20 every photo. Bitch.
Yeah. I used to be a big Metallica fan, but no. That shit's stupid.
I saw this meme that said that if you ever record yourself having sex and you're afraid that your ex will leak it, just lightly in the background play Disney music, because Disney will come through and copyright it and take it down. Right, straight up. And so the other one that you could do is Metallica, because they're so greedy that they would definitely have their people come through and take it down.
Straight up, Disney music is the best music to fuck to.
Sure, in a whimsical way. Right.
I could show you the world. Yeah, turn around.
Bam. Oh, and we're gonna take it. And we're back. Sorry about that. Just had to take a quick pit stop. on our road to the end of this podcast.
Dabs ahoy.
Now Muzzy had to pee. Okay, fine. I had to pee.
Right. And it just happened like that. But however, thank you for listening. You know, we appreciate you guys every week. Sorry that you didn't get an episode from us. It happens, but thanks for sticking around. Once again, shout out to, you know, everybody in Florida, whoever's listening to all of our stuff.
I hope you don't have fluoride in your water.
Ooh. Oh, nobody has fluoride in their water.
Nah, just gators.
Now they'll take your cat away. They will. Just like in the Midwest, that's coyotes. In the Midwest.
Or if you're in Australia, dingoes.
Or fucking kangaroos. Those things are fucking batshit wild.
And emus, too. Emus.
Yes, everyone remembers the fucking Great Emu War.
You have to.
Come on.
Come on. Come on. Follow us everywhere that you possibly can. You already know the handle. It's at SoulPods Podcast.
Boom.
Boom. Write us at protonmail.com. Same thing. SoulPods Podcast at protonmail.com.
Ow. Where else can they find us?
Under Big Rocks.
Celeste and us on SoulPods. Jesus. So glad.
You can find me rising from the cave in 3 days.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, thank you.
You can find me at your local supermarket ranting about Jesus outside with a sign that makes no sense to what I'm ranting about.
And you can catch me dealing with a whole lot of wood.
And you can catch me outside. How about that?
Question mark, blank, question mark.
You used to get it in your fishnets, now you only get it in your nightdress. Discard all the naughty nights for niceness, landed in a very common crisis. Everything's in order in a black hole, nothing seems to pity as the past though. That bloody memory's like an El Tabasco. Remember when you used to be a rascal? Oh, the boys are slack. The best you ever had, the best you ever had is just looking through a little book of sex tips. Remember when the bars were all electric? And now when she told she's gonna get it, I'm guessing that she'd rather just forget it. Clinging to not getting sentimental. Said she wasn't going, but she went still. Like a gentleman to be gentle. Was it a mecca double or a betting pencil? Oh, the boys are slag. The best.